Hi everyone, good evening. It's Thursday night live. Woohoo! I hope the kids are in bed, and if not, I hope they're either watching a movie or doing something fun and they're out of your hair, because this hour belongs to you guys. You deserve it. I am coming to you live from Montanu, courtesy of my lovely daughter for her upcoming birthday, and this is the Parapod. For those of you who remember, we were kind of toying with another name for this group, PWA, and because we have the whales, someone actually reached out to me and said, why not call it the Parapod? So we love that so much that we have revamped this. Thursday nights now belong to the parents. If you haven't seen it yet, Thursdays for the July schedule is up and running. Tonight, we're going to be joined by Erica Dunn, super excited about her, owner of the Pheasant and Dennis and Littlenecks. We're going to be joined next week on the 16th with Jacob Stapleton from Children's Cove and Amy Wyman from Good Grief Cape Cod. That's going to be super fun. The following week, Kevin Pacheco, owner of Vivid Event Production, and the founder of the Falmouth Drive-In. So we're going to be coming to you live. And actually, Amy right here has been put in charge of some fun family events over there. So I'm working hard on that for you guys. And then to close out July, we got Laura Shortino, owner of Turning Point Dance Studio. So we have quite the lineup for you guys tonight. Super excited. So let's just kind of go through really quick what we're going to be talking about. We're going to be talking with Erica Dunn. We're going to be asking you guys a question of the night, which is going to be involving party planning during COVID, and we want your ideas. So if you answer that question just by commenting, I'm going to enter your name into random.org, and you can be entered to win one of these amazing Cape Cod Quarantini shirts. Cape Cod Quarantini shirts are made actually courtesy of Lily Matthews, and she is a local student in Falmouth, and she came up with to do something fun during the summer, during COVID, to make a little extra money. So this week we're going to be giving away a shirt, and next week, so be sure to comment. Then we'll be surprising someone later after our stories from quarantine with a little kindness, and I'm really excited to share this one. So before we get going, I hope you have your cocktail or mocktail of the week. If you missed it, it was on our blog. It is the Summer Strawberry Negroni. It is excellent. I went up to the Pheasant myself and had one. And then for our sober moms or pregnant moms, we have the peach ginger iced tea. In addition, there was another spicy margarita that Erica was kind enough to let me share. Unfortunately, I drank it all before I got home, but that is a good one too. So if you are looking for those recipes, make sure to check out our blog. So I'm going to bring on Erica now. Good evening, Erica. She's about to come on. 3, 2, 1. Good evening, Erica. Welcome.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Thank you so much for having me.
I'm excited that we finally got to connect on this and have you on. I'm very excited about it. So Erica is the owner, co-owner with your husband. Yep. Is that correct? Okay.
Yes, correct.
Of the Pheasant in Dennis. And I have to say, so I had never been to eat there, Erica, and I came up to visit you last night because I started drooling over your menu and I was like, ooh, oysters, ooh, Greek food. Ooh, scallops. I'm going to drive my butt across the Cape and I'm going to get one of those. And yeah. I was like so excited by how great the food was.
Thank you. Yeah, it's a little bit of everything this summer. We're doing outdoor dining. We have 92 seats, a wood fire grill, these like awesome picnic tables, and it's definitely kid friendly. We've got like a couple items on the kids menu and good cocktails for moms. It's just it's got nice summer vibes, and we've definitely have been adjusting quite a bit. It's definitely different than what it was in the past years, but we're enjoying it and having fun. We're open Wednesday through Sunday, starting at 4 o'clock.
And I'll tell you what, guys, it's totally worth the drive up there. Everything's space apart. Erica and her staff do an amazing job. As soon as we were ready to go, I saw one of your staff members ready to sanitize and clean the table. And even have the little handheld sanitizer. And I was like, oh, my gosh, this is amazing.
I'm actually, I'm, I'm at work right now. I can even go of our outdoor dining. Hold on. Let's see how this is gonna go.
Erica's gonna show us her outdoor dining room, and at night.
Okay, so that's our wood.
Oh, look at this.
So we've got this going on every night. And then I'll show you our picnic table section and our fire pit. Hi, guys. So this is what the outdoor dining space.
Oh, we're losing you, Erica. Right. We're losing you a little bit.
Oh, did you get me back?
Yeah, I can hear you a little bit better now. We have Charlene who wants to know, do you have gluten-free options? I know there were vegan options and everything like that on the menu.
Yes. We do have several gluten-free options. We have a great mezzalafel and pickled veggie salad. We also have a great local cod served over sushi rice with a mixed green salad and dressing. And then we have a Thai-style braised beef that's gluten-free. And most of the items from our wood fire grill are gluten free, like our chicken, the lobster, the beef sausage. So there's plenty of gluten free options.
Nice. And so having been there, in addition, Erica and her team are also all about sustainability. So they bring everything out to you, and everything can be recycled into two trash barrels, both plastics and cans, as well as the to-go containers, which is absolutely amazing. And I'm telling you guys, date night with the kids, without the kids, take a drive up there. It's a nice hidden gem, a great spot to just go have a delicious meal. And I'm telling you, you will not be disappointed. Check out my Instagram. I got plenty of pictures up there.
Hi, Devin. You know. How are you?
Charlene says, oh, good. Sounds good. Yes, new place to eat, local and fresh. That's right, Charlene. You got to get there. So, Erica, tell us a little bit. Not only do you own the Pheasant, but before we get into everything else, so tell us about you and your family. Erica? You there?
I can't hear.
Oh. tell us a little bit about you and your child and your family. Oh, we're having
The sound?
Uh-oh. You're kind of cutting out a little bit. Hold on one second. You're cutting in and out, Erica. Do you want to, if you go back to the steps, I could hear you really good there.
I still can't hear.
All right, let's give Erica a minute to kind of, oh, there you are, Erica. Can you hear me better now? Let's see. Let's give Erica a minute. Let me give her a minute to kind of come back in. Erica, give me the thumbs up when you can hear me. If you need to go out and come back in, that's okay too. Let's give Erica a minute while she does that before we bring her back in. And while we're waiting for Erica to pop back in, why don't you guys start to answer if you want to win a Cape Cod Quarantini shirt from our buddy, Lily Matthews. Start sharing in the comments your party planning ideas. And we got Erica back, and here she comes in now. Hi, Erica.
Hi.
Okay, good. Excellent. So, Erica, tell us a little bit about you, your family, how you've been dealing with your businesses and your family during life in quarantine, essentially. Yeah.
So Well, normally my son is in daycare a couple days a week at Sunshine and Rainbows in Dennis. So obviously he's been home with us. And he's two. So he's not totally aware of what's going on. He's, you know, I think he's an only child. So not having other little ones around, I think, is definitely the toughest. Like, he'll see a kid at the beach and just, like, you know, like, be so cute. Like, so curious and excited. I'm like, all right, you know, give space. Let's take a step back. So I think that's definitely the hardest part, not really having any social interaction for him. And we were living in New York City before we moved to Cape Cod. So my sister and her kids are that way. So we don't have any, like, there aren't any cousins around or anything. So we really have just kind of been sticking to ourselves. So Leo, my son, is definitely eager to get together with some of his school friends. And then in terms of work, I mean, huge adjustment. We had to take a couple weeks to kind of figure out what we were going to do and how we were going to shift the business. We were doing takeout dinners for two in the beginning, like around in March, and then we slowly started to do takeout, and then it sort of evolved into outdoor dining, and we got our picnic tables together and the menu and started bringing staff back. But it was a pretty massive adjustment, and we had to build out an entire outdoor dining space, which we're psyched about now, but it required a lot of creativity and patience, and we have awesome, awesome customers that are just have been cheering us on all along the way that I think have been really, that's like what has kept us going. For Littlenecks, that has a totally different story. We were supposed to open the doors March 18th, so we're a brand new secondhand shop right in Dennis Village, like about a half mile down the road. And obviously, we were never able to open up. We had all these grand opening plans and events and ribbon cutting ceremonies and whatnot.
I remember,
put the shop together, and then it was just like a standstill. And I couldn't really figure out how I was going to make this work. You know, I had signed my lease. I'm, you know, paying rent each month, and I hadn't had a customer in the shop. So the shop was full, the racks were full, you know. It was just like, I felt like I created this beautiful little space that I wasn't able to share with anybody. So then I started doing virtual shopping appointments. So it was one-on-one shopping, and we would FaceTime, and I would put a little questionnaire together for the person who was booking the appointment, like, who are you shopping for, the age of your kids, could you describe your style? And then in advance, I'd pull pieces, and we would virtually shop the store together. So I would literally, you know, FaceTime around the store. And it was awesome. It was great because I got to really meet some amazing moms who have translated into, you know, in-store shopping customers now. But I was able to get a sense of what they were really looking for, their style. So I was able to kind of curate this shopping experience. And then delivering all across Cape. So that was like a really special time. And then we just started to, you know, get into the groove of things, build our customer base. And now we're open to shop in the store Thursday through Sunday from 11 to 4. So we have two people in the store at a time. And it's like a more normal shopping experience. But quite a bit of an adjustment. You know, trying out at, like, starting as a new business, trying to explain what we're doing, a secondhand shop, which is kind of unique for the Cape, you know, just there were a lot of obstacles there.
Absolutely. So you bring up Littlenecks, and so for anybody who doesn't know, Littlenecks is a children's consignment store that Erica founded. Okay. And why don't you tell everybody a little bit more about Littlenecks and why you wanted to do it?
So Littlenecks is a new and pre-loved children's clothing store. We're right in the heart of Dennis Village on 6A, so Main Street. We're close to the playground in Dennis Village or Dennis Public Market. And I wanted to open a children's clothing store, a children's secondhand clothing store for a while. And anytime I was in a different city or when I lived in New York, there were unbelievable children's secondhand shops. And when I had my son, I realized that they grow so fast, and this with the seasons constantly changing, and I'm very conscious about sustainability and upcycling and slow fashion, that I just found myself to buying secondhand. So that's kind of how the idea of Littlenecks was born. So I wanted to create a really small boutique experience, so you don't feel like you're sifting through, you know, millions of things, or that you feel like you're shopping at a, like a Salvation Army or anything like that. Like, it's this beautiful, elevated shopping experience, but still secondhand. And the store, the items in the store change every single day. There's new stuff coming in and going out all the time. So I'm having a lot of fun with it. And it's just this, like, really, really special creative space for me.
It's also because it's all about community, sustainability, which it's really important to encourage our kids. I mean, let's think about when you first get pregnant, right? The very first time, you get tons of stuff.
Yeah.
Tons of clothes. I mean, and I saw it more with my daughter than I did with my son, but I would have outfits that we only wore once. And it's like, oh, I wish we had had a chance to wear that again, but they grow so fast.
Right. Or you're like gifted a Patagonia snowsuit, but the size doesn't fit with the season.
With the timing of the season.
And then it's over. It's sitting in the attic and you're like, okay, what am I going to do with this? And, it's so great to give hand-me-downs to friends and family and things like that. But when you're looking with the kids, like, I just am constantly finding myself needing to, needing something. Oh, he needs more sweatshirts. He needs more PJs. You know, it's always something. So that's kind of the thought behind, a secondhand shop. And at the same time, I really wanted to have a space where filled with brands that I loved that were good quality. So you didn't have to it was at a reasonable price, but you didn't have to compromise on the quality or style.
Absolutely. Because you want something cute without, like you said, compromising the quality of everything. So actually, one of our followers just commented, and I'm having trouble on our end showing the comments, but she said, it's hard shopping with a toddler and a newborn, and I think virtual shopping might work for me. I love to see things in person, though, but so glad you are open again.
Oh, thank you so much. If you I'm still continuing to do the virtual shopping, and it is true. Like, if I bring my son in a store, I feel, like, scattered and hurried. I can't really,
I feel scattered. Last night, coming to dinner with my two kids, and you're like, "Oh, blah, blah, blah." And I'm like, and I'm sitting there as we're eating dinner, and they're like, "And I'm like, oh, I just want to eat."
I know, like, you're like, you're there, but you're like, your head somewhere else.
Yeah.
So like, I've been continuing the virtual shopping. So if anybody is interested in wanting to set up an appointment, they can find us on Instagram. It's Littlenecks Cape Cod, and just send me a message, and I'm happy to schedule a virtual shop. And we literally, like, just FaceTime around the shop together and the racks, and it's fun. And I've also done, like, a couple virtual shopping appointments where I've shopped with the child.
Really fun.
Yeah. So, and that's something that I didn't organize. The moms would be with their, son or daughter, and the daughter would tell me, I like pink, I like skirts, I don't like jeans. And I'm like, okay, well, then let's put something
together. What you like.
Yeah.
What an interesting thing. Now, do you think that would have kind of come up as naturally had COVID not happened? I almost feel like that's one of the first times I'm hearing that. And what a great opportunity to actually give ownership of letting our kids kind of, we let them pick them out at home. I mean, yeah, we're not always pleased with the choices of the matching outfit that they come up with. But to give them ownership of that is a really powerful thing at a young age.
It's so much fun. And it's also like with COVID, it's definitely an engaging activity. And I'll ask questions. I mean, the responses are hysterical. I'll ask questions to the kid, like, can you describe your style? And like, they're so funny. They're so funny.
And I'd also love to be a fly on the wall for those answers.
Unbelievably honest. I'm just like, okay, we don't, I'm putting that dress back. We don't have to look at it again.
Yeah.
You know?
Like the polka dots. Got it.
Yeah. And there's definitely trends I'm seeing with the little ones, you know, anything mermaid, any little girl that I talk to wants something with a mermaid, and the boys, whales, sharks. It's all about like any nautical sea life.
So mermaids and nautical and sea life. So basically the ocean is in right now, everybody.
It's very specific to Cape Cod.
Yes. We better tell Lily, who's making these shirts, she should start doing mermaid prints. Lily, did you hear that? Mermaid prints and nautical prints, and then people can hand them down to Erica and they can be in the store. I love it.
Well, these are like these quarantini shirts, like, we have to hang on to these because these are going to be a vintage hot commodity.
Look at this one. This one's, it's 3/4 length. It's blue with the red.
Yeah.
You've got like this pink one I'm like in love with.
Oh, wow.
I really like this one though, because I feel like it pops.
I like the baseball tee. Amy, I think I'm going to get myself like one of those.
Yes.
It's also a good gift.
I know, right? When I saw that she was making these, I was like, what a creative kid. I need a bunch of those, and what a great idea. It's got the shark in it and everything.
Very cool.
And then the olive is a beach ball.
Oh, and there's like all those like wine groups on Facebook.
Oh,
like,
yes.
That would be a perfect thing to put in a bag.
Yes, all you ladies in the Cape Cod Get Wine group, you need to go visit our friend Lily at CapeCodQuarantini.com.
Yeah.
Help this little entrepreneur make some money this summer. So, you know, hey, if our kids aren't in front of screens and they are doing something productive or having fun, I'm all about it. Yeah. So Littlenecks also does this fun little subscription type box. Tell everybody about the Camp Littlenecks.
Yeah, so we just launched Camp Littlenecks, which was a 3-month subscription box service, and we either ship it or you can pick it up in store. But each month is themed, and it comes with a box of like awesome crafts for the kids. So for June, it was all about like nature. So there was a garden markers, a DIY fairy jar. There was a cool DIY bug jar, and you open up this box and there's like a handful of crafts, a scavenger hunt for the kids. And then July we still have a few, and you can buy the months individually. You don't have to buy the 3-month subscription. And July it's all sea life, so it's sea creature masks, color your own beach ball, a matching game, a memory game, but it's all beach themed. And then August is like safari animal themed. So and there's like a kaleidoscope. They're fun. They're just a lot of fun. And every month we have on our website a list of what's included in each month. But we sprinkle in some surprises here and there. And then we just did a July 4th bonus box, which was like a DIY pinwheel and a picture frame craft. Just really cute.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how do people, I have the website right here. How do people sign up? What's the cost? What do they need to do?
So on the website, on the top right-hand corner, you'll see a shop section. And under shop, you'll see it's separated by new and pre-loved. And in new, you can sign up for Camp Littlenecks. I should also mention on the website, so we do have a small selection of our secondhand items on the website. However, it is a small, small sliver of what we have in store. We have such a large inventory that is changing every day, and it changes so quickly that I keep just a tiny little teaser on the website, but you've really got to come and shop or do a virtual shop because
it's changing all it's the changing. Time.
Yeah, it's changing, you know, and it really, every day it looks like a new store, which is the fun of it.
Yeah, I like it. So, what else? Do you want to mention anything else about Littlenecks or anything like that that you feel everybody should know?
So along the lines of the crafts, we just launched a jewelry making kit, which comes with like a custom Littlenecks, like a Littlenecks zipper pouch. And it's, you know, working on those like fine motor skills where they're beading, and they can make bracelets that have different words on them. So they're all like educational craft activities. And on our web, that isn't on our website yet, but it will be soon.
Okay.
Also on our website, we have the signature craft buckets that come with instructions of all these different shell crafts that you can do. And in the bucket, you get everything, the paint, the paintbrushes, the googly eyes, the glitter, all that good stuff. So the crafts are one thing to look out for at Littlenecks. And then something else I do want to mention about Littlenecks, we're different than traditional consignment shops where we buy the clothes outright. So you don't have to wait for the items to sell in order to get paid. You either get, there are two options. You either get paid in the form of a check for items that Littlenecks would like to buy, or you get a larger percentage in store credit. So the idea is really you're upcycling, you're shopping for the next size, or you're bringing in old clothes, and then you can shop for the next size or season, or maybe for another child or for a friend. So if anybody is interested, if anybody is interested in selling to Littlenecks, just shoot us an email or a note on Instagram, and we can set up an appointment so you can drop off your clothes. And it usually takes me about a day or two to go through everything, and it's a pretty simple process.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, that's good to know. So if you're interested in consigning, or if you're interested in a virtual appointment or going in person, shoot Erica an email, an Instagram message, on the website or on her Insta or on her social media, and she will definitely help you out. I think this is great. Okay. Erica, tell me, let's circle back to the community and Cape Cod, because I know you're about sustainability and community. What do you think, you having not been from here, what do you think are some of the strengths of this community for families to take advantage of?
Absolutely. I mean, the real community feel of Cape Cod is something that really has taken me back. Like I said, with the restaurants, our customers have been rooting us on the whole way. They've been unbelievably supportive and just like excited to see us grow and change. But in terms of like resources and things like that, Cape Cod Children's Place is an unbelievable organization. So I'm sure many of you are familiar with Cape Cod Children's Place. Items that Littlenecks does not buy for the shop, it might not be the right fit for us or a brand we might not carry, the sellers have an option to donate the items. And we partner with Cape Cod Children's Place. So like talking about community and, you know, creating the sustainable culture, it's just, it keeps it on Cape. It goes, those clothing donations go back to Cape Cod families. So we get to partner with really cool organizations like that. And for the restaurant, we work a lot with Capabilities. I'm not sure if everybody's familiar with Capabilities, but they have their market in Dennis is open right now, and they just opened a new market in Chatham. I mean, unbelievable community. And they did our gardens at the restaurant in our raised planter bed. So if you come stop by the restaurant, they did a beautiful job, and we just love supporting those sort of local organizations. And I feel like we're so lucky to have those kinds of, you know, that sense of community and those organizations so close to us. I mean, literally right down the road.
I feel like it's every guest I've had on, they really love it. It really is. Cape Cod is such a unique community, and having grown up here, I didn't always appreciate that as when I was younger, but having left here after growing up and returned and now raising a family here, it's become more apparent. And so then to hear people like yourself and other people who are, you know, we call you transplants, if you will, or Cape Cod barnacles, wash ashores. And
I don't think I've heard barnacle. I'm interested.
My husband actually calls me a barnacle because my parents were living in Sandwich, but because they had moved there a couple months before I was born, my maternity doctor was off Cape, so I was born off Cape. So he calls me a barnacle, which I kind of think is funny. But it's another, you know, that is the reoccurring theme, is it's such a great community. And when push comes to shove, you know, this community really will have each other's backs, especially when it comes to the families.
Totally.
The people who are invested in the families will continue to reinvest in the families. And I think that's a really special thing about raising kids here, because it really does produce a really good childhood. So are there things that you think that we need to do better, or where do we need to go looking forward to the future?
Yeah, I think just loving each other and our neighbors, you know, it doesn't even have to be on a large scale. It can just be, you know, writing a nice card and putting it in a neighbor's mailbox, or, you know, a customer at the restaurant made my son a mask and it meant so much to me, you know, it just those little things are things to, you know, just continue to remind ourselves of, to do. And it's so simple to write a note, or, you know, drop off some cookies at a friend's house that you think might just need something to brighten their day.
It really is. It's so simple to just do one small act of kindness, whatever it is, every day. And so that's what I try to do. I try to do at least one thing every day. And I think that's how I focus getting through everything. I mean, I was already doing it, but to really refocus on that. And that's kind of what COVID has done for me, is move forward, be grateful for what you have. And how can I do even one small thing every day to make it my community a little bit better? So I appreciate you saying that, because I think this community really strives to do that, and we should continue to do that and use that as an example for our children and lead by example.
Right.
We have a couple questions for you. Second, I'm just going to read them right here. Can we do a trade for clothes? I bring in clothes that don't fit my kids and get bigger sizes. So you kind of touched a little bit about that. That would be, once it sells, they use the credit.
Right. Oh, so how it works is, so definitely whoever asked that question, check out our how to sell page on our website, littlenextcapecod.com. So how that would work is, for example, you would bring in your clothes and I would go through the items and say, okay, this is what Little Next would like to buy, and X amount, we can either give you X amount in the form of a check or X amount in store credit. So with that store credit, you could definitely buy for the next size.
Excellent. So I'm going to pop up, because you and I kind of talked a little bit about, you had some questions. So we kind of did a different question of the night tonight. We want you to share some COVID birthday planning ideas with us. Both of us actually have children with birthdays coming up.
Yeah.
So we want to hear some of your ideas. And I'm having trouble showing the comments on screen, so I'm going to read one of them to you. Someone said, have a beach pool party with kiddie pools set up all around and distance them apart. Each kid can play in their own pool.
That's cute.
That's cool, because you could get those like little like kiddie pools like when we were little, so the big ones. Hopefully they're not on back order right now, but you could use anything. I mean, my son was using sleds today, baby infant sleds, to fill up with hose water and sit in. That was entertaining.
Or fill up your sandbox. That works.
Yeah, why not? Get creative. There's no rules anymore. Does anybody else have any ideas while we're waiting? You can win a Cape Cod quarantini shirt. Erica and I would like to hear some of your ideas. And while we're waiting for a couple more comments, Erica, we as I told you, we do a random act of kindness every week. So our audience is invited to fill out a form, and they we have two different forms. They can nominate like a good friend of theirs, a bestie, or they can nominate someone random. It can be anyone. And we ask them to share a little bit about that person. And then we call and surprise them on air and award them a fun little prize. So it's always actually one of my favorite parts of doing this show so far is to actually call and surprise them, because with the exception of one, everybody has cried, which I absolutely love because they're like so excited. So tonight, I actually happen to know both the nominee and the winner tonight. I was in a breastfeeding support group with them, which predated Cape Cod Moms and is kind of where my inspiration came from. So I'd met these ladies once upon a time, and the team has picked this as the winner tonight. So we're going to be calling them. We're going to be calling Phoebe Lambert. And hopefully she is listening right now, and we're going to call her live so everybody can see. And she was nominated by her friend, Sarah Barbero. So we are going to call and surprise them right now. Okay. Hold on. Can you hear that, Erica?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Hopefully Phoebe is either watching with us. And she's already put the kids to bed, and I'm not ruining bedtime. I'm sorry if I am, Phoebe. If not, we'll leave her a message.
The suspense.
Hey, please, please leave a message, and I'll call you.
Okay,
back.
We're going to leave her a message.
Thanks. Have a great day.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hi, Phoebe. It's Amy from Cape Cod Moms and Erica from the Pheasant and Littlenecks. And we are calling to surprise you on the Parent Pod, our weekly Thursday late night live, as you are this week's big winner of a gift basket. You were nominated by your friend, Sarah May. And I just want to read you what she said about you. She said, she makes me laugh when I want to cry. She makes me stop and think when I want to judge. She makes me smile when I want to give up. Without her, raising kids would not have the same energy and spark. She makes me a better person and brings alternative perspectives to my children. I love her. So Phoebe, text me later and I'll take care of getting you your basket this week, but congratulations. Well-deserved, and it really is special hearing how special of a person and a mom and a friend you are to Sarah and to, I'm sure, many others. So congratulations. Thanks, Phoebe. Phoebe is also the feelings teacher extraordinaire in the Mashpee Public Schools, and she's so wonderful. She has a lot of energy herself, so I'm glad Sarah actually nominated Phoebe. It's interesting because they're very similar, the two ladies. So Phoebe's on with us right now. You didn't answer, Phoebe. I can see you. Call me back if you want. Do we have anybody else who would like to win a Cape Cod quarantini shirt from our friend Lily Matthews? She's a local student. She is in junior high school from Falmouth, and she came up with a summer project to make these fun shirts right here, Cape Cod Quarantini with the shark and the ball. And all you have to do, there's my cousin, is comment with some COVID party planning ideas for us. Some COVID party planning ideas for Erica and I. We want to hear what you are doing for parties. The drive-bys are done and everything like that. Do you have any funny stories to share with us, Erica, about quarantine and or just parenting stories in general?
Well, so we did my son's second birthday earlier this week, and we had a pretty awesome, you know, socially distant quarantine small gathering. We had Pizza Barboni come to the house, and they did one of those micro parties Unreal. I mean, it was a blast. And my son had an amazing time. He ate 4 slices of pizza. He was dancing. The pizzas, of course, are amazing. But they park the truck in the driveway, and it's just, it's cool. You know, like, the truck is awesome. They do such a good job, and it comes with, like, a salad and a dessert and all the paper plates and everything. So you basically, you don't have to do anything. It was, like, the first party that I felt like I really was able to relax and enjoy. You know, because I feel like every, like, birthday party or anything you organize, you're constantly running around. This was just perfect. And then I called the fire department, the Dennis Fire Department, and they brought a fire truck. And they, like, did the sirens, and they parked in the driveway, and we could look at all the buttons. It was really, really special.
Very nice.
Yeah.
How old did he turn?
2. So, like... Fire trucks are really big right now.
Yeah, they are. They're loud. They make noise. They're red. I mean, who doesn't love a good fire truck, right?
It was a hit. It was a total hit.
Excellent. Excellent. Hold on. I'm just trying to go back here to the comments. What? Any other fun stories, Erica?
I would say, like, quarantine fun stories. I mean, just the normal, like, silly shenanigans of, you know.
I got one for you. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. And hopefully my husband's not listening, because he was ready to kill me last time I shared the same story on live a couple weeks ago. But I told him that Dr. Fauci, this was early on, okay? This was early on when experts were experts. And, I told them that Dr. Fauci and the CDC had said, listen, there's no good loving anymore. There's no snuggling. We have to stay 2 feet apart in the bed at least. You know, I might catch COVID from you. And that bought me a couple,
couple months. He believes that?
You know, he works at a grocery store. It's high risk. You know, he was getting hazard pay. He's like, okay. Well, I guess that makes sense.
You have to follow the rules.
It didn't last very long that he bought it for, but
it's so funny.
I thought that was really funny. I was like,
That's very good.
It was like the same with the kids. I'm like, oh, sorry, you can't do this. It's against the rules.
Yeah.
It was more I didn't want.
I think I need to get more creative.
I know, right? Exactly. All right, let's see if we have any more comments for this. I don't know why all my technology is being like this tonight. Oh, really quick before I go back to the comments and before we wrap up for the night.
Yeah.
Tell everybody a little bit about the 2 drinks that we highlighted from the Pheasant this week.
Yeah. So Amy came over and we talked about the summer Negroni. So it's just a really nice, it's a classic Negroni, but it has roasted strawberries in it. This season we're doing batch cocktails. So they're like individually batched in these really cute little containers. These like little pint size containers. So we've got the summer Negroni, and then also Amy had a non-alcoholic spicy margarita, but it definitely can be alcoholic. So our bartender, Kristen, she batches everything in-house every day. And then there's several non-alcoholic options as well, iced teas, lemonades. But some of the alcoholic batch cocktails we have are like painkillers and old fashions, and we do martinis. Ooh, maybe I should just relabel it as a Cape Cod quarantini. We do like a gin martini. Yeah, these great icebox martinis. So if we post our batch cocktails on our Instagram, Pheasant Cape Cod. So you can always follow along, and we're always coming up with new stuff.
Amazing. And I really like how you bottle it. You bring it back, you bring it out. Even like the non-alcoholic spicy margarita, I took a couple of sips. I brought it home, and then I drank it for breakfast. It was really good. I mean,
you could, yeah, Yeah. And then, of course, you can.
I mean, you could add an alcohol if you wanted to, but yeah, I mean, it is just fine on its own. And perfect if our pregnant mamas have a hankering for, you know, a Bloody Mary or a spicy margarita. This is a great way to get some fruits and vegetables into yourself. And there's no alcohol, which is great.
And like, if you're bringing it at home, you know, pour it in like a nice cocktail, like, you know, a nice glass, or make it feel special.
Absolutely. I brought home your lemonade, and I had the lemonade. Especially, I had a blueberry lemonade. That blueberry lemonade was out of this world, by the way, Erica. My kids loved it. I loved it. I need the recipe because I want to make it.
Thank you.
So let's go pull our winner for comments about. We only have one for our entry. So it's Charlene Politi, who is our winner for Cape Cod Quarantini shirt. So we'll be in touch, Charlene. You can pick pink or the lovely pink short sleeve one with the blue lettering. Or we have the white one with the red lettering right here, 3/4 length sleeves. So I just want to thank Erica again for tuning in tonight. You can meet her at the Pheasant in Dennis or Littlenecks. And she's an amazing asset to this community. So I really hope you all check it out. Go up there and eat. Contact her about shopping. Back to school shopping is going to start soon. And Erica, I'd love to have you back on. And maybe we can do a virtual one at the store for a late night live where we can talk about school clothes.
I would love it. Let's do a little back to school special.
Yes. Maybe we can have a couple of the Cape Kids cast, my kid or another one that we're close with, you know, so we maintain social distance, but they can pick out some of their favorites to highlight for back to school shopping.
Awesome. Well, I'm back to work.
All right. Thanks, Erica.
So much for having
me. Thank you, Erica. We'll see you soon.
Amen. Thank you, Cape Cod Moms.
Thanks. Bye, Erica. So that was Erica Dunn, everybody, from Local Mom, from The Pheasant, and Littlenecks and Dennis. Just remember, we will be here next week. We will be joined by the Jacob Stapleton from Children's Cove. We will also be joined by Amy Wyman, the Amy Wyman from our team and Good Grief Cape Cod. And we're going to be having some fun. Stay tuned for upcoming this week for the cocktail and mocktail of the week. I'm hoping to get our good friend Davey, if he's watching, over here to be our guest bartender. And we'll also be doing some more giveaways, including a Cape Cod Quarantini shirt from our buddy Lily Matthews. So thanks to Lily Matthews for creating these for our Question of the Night giveaway for the next 2 weeks. And if you guys want to check out her shirts or order your own, CapeCodQuarantini.com, and tell her Cape Cod Mom sent you. And if you, your business, or if you're interested in joining our team or joining us for Late Night Lives for the Parent Pod, we'd love to hear from you. So send us an email, info@CapeCodMoms.com. And I'd say cheers with an empty glass, but I don't want to do that in case it's bad luck. But I hope you all have a good night. I hope the kids are in bed and have a wonderful weekend, everybody. Thanks so much. We'll see you next week.